field more. Okay, so the linebackers need more depth on our defense to cover the passes, and our offense, we've got to open it up more. We've got to complete some passes downfield to make them respect the pass. If they don't respect the pass, they're going to kill us. And Arizona State ran a couple screen plays that were really nice as well, which will slow our blitzing package down quite a bit.
Hey, Matt, it looked to me like in the last two possessions that we scored touchdowns on that we kind of it was almost a hurry-up offense because there was a few minutes left in the first half.
That's the key to our offense.
We got away. We went away from the run and more to the quick pass, maybe. And maybe that's part of the deal in terms of setting up the run in the second half, the fact that he was able to.
Would you like to come up here?
No, I just want to ask you.
Yeah, sure.
He was able to set up some of the shorter passes, maybe
bring
the backers in and set up the run later on in the second half.
Well, if you know, I mean, yes. No, absolutely. You're absolutely correct. You know, throw some short passes, complete them. But if you notice, the long passes, the intermediate passes that we're having him throw haven't been connecting. Okay, he's got a little bit of happy feet. He's got some pressure around him. Anytime you can get some pressure around the quarterback and he gets a little happy feet and he's dancing a little bit, he's not setting his feet and throwing it, which is what we're seeing. Okay, he's a young quarterback and that's fine. There's going to be growing pains. But I really think that we've taken Arizona State's best shot. I'm not saying that it's going to go, you know, they're not going to notch it down a level in the second half. They're going to keep bringing it. But I think our coaches, as evidence in the Tennessee game, are going to make the adjustments. And they've got a few more wrinkles to throw at them in that I think we'll do fine. I never talk in terms of spreads, point spreads. I don't care. A one-point victory is the same as a 70-point victory. Really don't care as long as you win. What's up, buddy?
We turn you in white.
What is the better team?
As I'm looking at it right now, who's the best team, period, right now, from what I've seen in the first half? I'd say Arizona.
Exactly.
Who's played the best? I'd say who played the best game so far right now? I'd say Arizona. What remains to be seen is what happens in the second half. Who makes the best adjustments? And then we'll see what happens after that. 350. Dude, they've outgained us by 100 yards. Their quarterback has been kicking our butt left and right. The receivers have been catching balls. Our linebackers have been sucking up and giving them passes, and we haven't done anything. We should be down 7 points, or more than, or at least, or we should have 7 less points because we get to go out an interception on defense. Now, the other thing is special teams. Okay? We need to suck it up on special teams to make some plays. We got some tremendous athletes. Along with that, our defense, we need another turnover. We need a 1 or 2 turnovers going our way to give us more of an advantage. Okay? It's not necessarily just what you see, offensive, defense, yardage both ways. What are the plays and the lack of a better term, the things that you don't necessarily go into a game plan.
Intangibles.
The special teams. Thank you, intangibles. Thanks, Chris. Thank you, Chris, my friend Chris back there. Intangibles. The turnovers, the individual efforts, the hustle. You know, that's what's going to make a difference. Okay? So, we can pull this game out. We got a 4-point lead, I believe. 28-24, we got a 4-point lead. And, you know, go Ducks. And, you know, this is our first real test of a real team. Let's face it. Okay? It's not going to get any easier than this. All right? We got Stanford next week. We got to rock and roll and find it. Remember, we got a sophomore quarterback. This is the first time the guy's been starting. You know, if we had Jeremiah Masoli, and I don't like to talk about the guys in the past, but let me tell you what. It doesn't matter what Ole Miss record. Ole Miss doesn't have the accoutrements that Masoli had at Oregon, brother. I know. Sorry. I didn't mean to throw a big word at you. Listen, you guys. I see smoke coming out of your ears up in the front row here. Take it easy. All right. Okay? I'll lowbrow for a little minute. We got to kick some ass.
Yeah.